The recipes we're doing today are really geared towards the home cook, just to show how easy it is to use pez powder and the different uses, the different flavors, on how you can apply them to food or beverages. It's so easy to do, whether it's salmon or shrimp or tuna, or whether it's, you know, making your own cocktail at home, sprinkle on fruit, you have it in your pantry, cut some fruit. So it really is just something you can pull out and kind of just go at it and not spend a lot of time cooking. So let me kind of introduce you to the ingredients a little bit here. We've got this beautiful ahi tuna, which we've cut into blocks, just a center cut, which is just very clean and there's no sinew. And then we're going to use pez powder black, which is our chipotle and lime seasoning. And we've got all the ingredients to make a tomato cucumber pico de gallo. And then on the side, we're gonna do a Mexican fruit salad and we're gonna sprinkle pez powder original on that, kind of showing you how you can use the two flavors. To that, I'll get started on the tostada. I'm gonna put this guy in here like this, push it down so that it fries evenly. And you kind of turn it over a couple times. It's not difficult to know, but when you put it in there, if it starts browning too fast, just turn down the fire a little bit and let it go a little bit slow like this. Push it down. And now it's kind of flat. You can see it's starting to brown just a little bit there. But really important when frying things, you wanna season the fried product when it's hot because it sticks better. So I'm just gonna kind of sprinkle a little bit on there, not too much because we're gonna put some on the tuna and season the salad as well. In this case, I've got the pez powder black, chipotle and lime seasoning. And I'm gonna take the tuna and I'm just gonna dredge it in there, kind of lay it in, pat it down a little bit so it grabs as much seasoning as possible. Really quickly, we don't wanna overcook the fish. This quality of tuna, you really wanna keep it at medium rare to rare. Because the quality of the tuna is so nice, you don't want to take away from that. So you certainly want to keep it a nice red color in the middle. So very, very fast, flip this guy over. You see it's got a nice little blackening color here. And so literally it's like 15, 20 seconds per side, and that's it. I'm going to take this guy out. So that is all the cooking we're going to do. And make sure you have a sharp knife. I'm going to sharpen up my nice knife here. So first what we're gonna do is we're gonna cut these baby tomatoes in half. Do your thing. I do about equal parts tomato and cucumber. You can absolutely do more cucumber, more tomatoes, really up to you. Now the onion, I've peeled this. I use a red onion because I think it's a little bit less, it's a little less bitey than a white onion. I'm just gonna kind of slice it. I'm keeping this connected here. Just kind of finely dice it like this. Definitely not as much onion as tomatoes and cucumber, but this is a Serrano chili. And the difference between a serrano, it looks kind of like a jalapeno, but it's a little skinnier. Definitely spicier. I'm not gonna put the entire chili in there because I don't want it to be too spicy. And I'm gonna stop till I get to like, this is like really where all the seeds are. So I'm gonna stop right there. That's definitely gonna be spicy enough. And then we've got some cilantro. And I'm gonna just go right at the bunch. I've pre-washed it and dried it. You know, I'm cutting it right like this, what's called chiffonade. We're gonna season it now. Kosher salt, some freshly ground pepper. Freshly ground, of course. And I've got these Meyer lemons. Again, I'm gonna use the Meyer lemons. You can use limes, you can use lemons, you can use whatever, you know, sour citrus you like. I've got a little bit of extra virgin olive oil. I think it's something unique about the ceviche. It kind of gives it a little bit of a round, fatty mouthfeel. And now what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna toss it like this. Okay, so for our garnish, I've got some red radishes. Now we're gonna cut these the little stem off. What I have here is called a mandolin, and the mandolin's a little device that allows you to slice it very, very thin. Be very, very careful because it is super sharp. So slice it like this, so you can see it's super, super thin. And then I'm gonna use a little bit of the green part of the scallion. So when we developed pez powder, we quickly saw that it was so versatile that it was really great on so many different dishes, food, beverages, and once we were to get to three different flavors, then the sky was the limit. There were so many different things we could do. So just for example, in the bar, you know, you can use it for, you know, margaritas and Bloody Marys and micheladas and mocktail margaritas that don't have alcohol. It's like my kids love to drink, like just a lemonade rimmed with pez powder. We're gonna assemble the tostada. Here's the avocado crema we made earlier. And put as much as or a little as you like, and then we're gonna put some of this pico de gallo. Ooh, I can still feel that chili in my mouth. I'm gonna cut it nice and thin. You look at that gorgeous color. And then some avocado, some radishes. and then some of our scallions. Yeah, why not? Let's just put a little bit on the plate. All the little things that make a dish so nice and presentable. Put some pez powder on the lemon like that. Even take some pez powder, kind of sprinkle on the plate. You know, really gives the dish like another whole nother level of texture. So we love using fresh ingredients out of our own garden. We're really fortunate to have an amazing, you know, kind of garden around the house. We use garlic chives and rosemary and lavender. We've got sorrel, which is like a lemony spinach. We've got a bay leaf tree in the back. You know, during the summertime and spring, we'll start planting tomato seeds and cucumbers and squash and that kind of stuff. So, I mean, the ability to be able to cook in the kitchen and then say, oh my gosh, I really want to put some certain herb in there, sage or thyme, running out to the backyard and grabbing and throwing it to the dish is just like such a plus. Growing herbs and vegetables is something that it's so easy to do once you find the right place for it. And not everything grows great. It's got to have the right sun, it's got to have the right soil, the right water, the right drainage, that kind of stuff. So, but when you do find that, it really is kind of a no-brainer.